I said I had had problems with my hip for like 10 years. And I knew that the joint was degraded. I didn't really act on it because, like I said, I was not on my feet all day. I was sitting at a desk, so it was manageable. Mm-hmm. But once I retired and I wasn't sitting at the desk all day and I was out doing all the stuff I wanted to do, you know, living the dream, right? It just was too annoying. And then it got to the point where I wasn't doing the things I wanted to do. And I said, this isn't what I signed up for, right?
So in recent time, we've been doing total joint arthroplasty or hip and knee joint replacement for many years. But there have been several recent advancements in the technology that have allowed us to do this more efficiently, more accurately, and to allow patients to have a better, faster outcome than we did before. One of those technological advancements is the Mako, which is owned by a company called Stryker, but it allows us to use a robotic arm to perform partial knee, total knee arthroplasty, and total hip arthroplasty, or total knee and hip replacements, in a faster and more accurate manner, and then that allows us to have a better patient outcome in the end. It's a robotic arm that assists me in surgery. I'm still doing the surgery as well as the other surgeons who perform the Mako-assisted procedures, but it allows us to just be more accurate and doesn't allow us to go outside of a realm where we know we need to be in. So it just gives us additional feedback.
Bacchus has a nice program where they ask you to, you know, come in before the surgery. It's like an hour and a half seminar. They tell you everything that's going to happen. And all of that was really helpful.
We try and get you back to your full functional outcome that you had before. Now, obviously, we don't want you running marathons on these things. They're not designed for that. But getting you back to your golf, everyday walking, swimming, cycling, doubles, tennis, all that is appropriate.
I'm still grateful. I mean, I'm working on my car now, you know, crawling in and under that, and just stuff I couldn't do before. It's all up to me on, you know, how much I exercise, how much I stretch, how rigorous I decide I want my recovery to be. And I don't know how everybody is, but I like the fact that I can control how I'm recovering or how I'm feeling. And I couldn't do that before with the joint.